I mean, Robert Schumann is really another great romantic composer who really, the birthday was really 1 year apart, but he was not only a famous composer, he wanted to be a pianist, but he couldn't do that because of a permanent injury. And he was a music critic, so he was actually the one who made the public notice young talents like Chopin or Brahms. But he had this condition called bipolar. So he would one day wake up super excited, and another day wake up feeling depressed and doesn't get up from bed. And he even signs his pieces, Florestan and Isabius. One character, they're both from a book that he likes. One of the characters, Isabius, is really a outgoing, you know, everything is exciting and super energetic. The other one, Florestan, is the introvert, the poetic. So he signs these two characters at the end of each most of his pieces. And why do I mention that? Because this next piece, second ballade, really is nothing like Chopin. It has this very quiet opening, and then suddenly this energy just bursts to us. So I guess Chopin not only was dedicating the piece, he was really making a portrait of Robert Schumann. And of course, Robert Schumann in return not only dedicated some pieces to Chopin, he even put a piece called Chopin in one of his larger works called Carnival. And it's really a very poetic, beautiful piece, but Chopin didn't like it. When he heard it, he really was really quite mad. And I think it's because Schumann did such a wonderful job. It was not only a portrait of Chopin, but in the style of Chopin's writing, and he was offended. And he now portrayed a crazy piece after Mr. Schumann.
Thank you. Thank you.